It's indestructible.
Soaked in maple syrup or peppermint, any flavor you wanted. Now, you just open up your little pad, see?
Right.
And you press your finger on it, and then you taste your finger. Peppermint. Any time of day. Or cherry.
Wouldn't the pad get disgusting after a while?
Disgusting how?
I don't know. Keep touching the thing with your filthy fingers. One day, that flavor pad's like some mattress you find in the dump.
You're right, it's no good. Tam, did you get your performance chart?
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
Well, look at mine. I don't get it. Good, fair, fair, good, and then it falls into the red in the focus department.
Yeah, well, you know, Nick, that's because you're a dreamer.
You know? I'm not a dreamer.
Well, you're not the most focused person. That's, you're a dreamer.
Yeah. I'm a dreamer. Hey, you want to feel something? Come here. Sit in this chair. Come here. Okay. Check this out. Whoa. Sit back. Oh, this is some chair.
You like it?
Yeah.
I feel this.
What is that? Lumbar spine. Oh, that is good.
Yeah.
It's all there for you. All you got to do is focus. Just work a little bit harder. I'm telling you, you can get bumped up to sandpaper with me, and the world opens up.
You know what, man? You could really sack out in this thing.
Yeah, and I'm telling you, your numbers aren't that bad. I mean, it's just focus. If you put together everything else, you got a really strong thing going on. I think you and I could... Nick. Nick! I gotta get back to work.
Yeah. Good talk.
Yeah, good talk. Remember what I said.
Focus.
Just get into orange.
That's all I need.
Don't worry about yellow. Just orange.
Do you ever just watch your hand?
No.
I was just looking at my hand today. It was like a separate thing. It was picking up papers. It tapped on my desk. It sat in my lap. It's like a sidekick, my little ugly sidekick. It's very odd.
Spray it on dog poo, and the poo disappears.
Disappears?
Yes!
Where does it go?
Who knows, but the thing is, you come up with something that gets rid of dog turds, you are home free, my friend. Mm. Home free.
You mean where they suck the fat out?
Mm-hmm. There's a thing about it in here.
You're fine. You don't need to get fat sucked out.
I don't know if we have a little extra money.
No, we don't have extra money.
We have a little.
I don't have to get fat sucked out.
Hello? Timmy. Timmy, check this out.
What?
You know that invention of mine that makes turds disappear?
Ugh.
I got a name for it. Vaporize. It's just like vaporize, only you add an O, so you got poo right there in the middle.
Yeah, I get it.
Do you see how perfect it is? Maybe even underline the poo. Vaporize.
All right.
Vaporize.
Goodbye.
Nick?
Mm-hmm.
What do you want?
Nothing.
Strange?
No.
Well, I told him about my invention.
What invention?
Vaporize!
Nick, you got a cute name. That's it. It's not an invention. It's an idea. It's nothing.
Not according to Dimitriov. He thinks I'm really onto something.
tent. Not one bug.
Guess what? I went over to Dimitrov's a couple nights ago and we were running all these experiments in his sink. He is having a ball with this thing.
What thing?
You didn't tell Debbie about my invention?
No, I'm sorry. No. I didn't. Please, go ahead. Please, this is great.
Okay, check it out. It's a spray can, okay? And you spray it on dog poo, and the poo disappears.
That is an awesome invention. And we could sure use it.
First of all, it's not an invention, okay? It's nothing. I mean, how does it work?
It's a spray can, and you spray it on.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah, I know, but I mean, what makes it disappear?
Guys are here. This is Dimitrov. Dimitri, these are our best friends in the universe.
How do you do?
Give Tim the flash, Big D.
Okay. Yeah, take it.
Goggles. Shine it right on her, buddy boy.
Her?
Face it, they all have to do their business. That's right! One spray, problem solved. Is this some kind of video trick?
No!
It's the miracle spray. One spray, and Doggy Doo disappears. No fuss, no muss, no tools to clean, no robot arms. How do you work it? I don't know! Too good to be true?
No!
Vaporize, because life is tough enough.
Available in stores everywhere.
Now's a good time to break the big news.
I have decided to run for Congress.
Congress?
Mm-hmm. No, I'm serious. Yeah, I mean, not the big Congress, of course. The little one. The little one.
The little one?
Yeah. Actually, I don't even know if it's the Congress. It might be the State Senate. I can't remember. Anyway, I'm super excited because we are so lucky and we have so much. And I feel like we need to give something back. So I've decided I'm going to run for Congress or State Senate or whatever. And my main platform is going to be the environment. State Senate.
Environment, like the whole environment?
Yeah. I believe in all environments, and I'm going to say it.
And now, for reserve, flood. Oh, fly, oh boy.
Woo!
Come on, kids, flood time!
Come on, Jerry Bones, get down in the flood here! Flood, kids, flood!
I love flan. Do you love flan? What is flan?
God, you are in...
We're getting the little itty-bitty pool?
Mikey, it's not a little itty-bitty. The square one's a little itty-bitty. We're getting the bean-shaped model, right?
A little itty-bitty bean.
It's not a little itty-bitty bean. It's an average-sized bean, Mikey. And I got news for you, my friend. There are kids in parts of the world who would walk 50 miles through quicksand just so they could stick a toe in your swimming pool. And I got news for you about beans, too, mister. There are kids who would eat beans because they've had nothing to eat their whole life but leaves and bark and roots. And I guarantee you, none of them has ever heard of your big show-off flan or flan or whatever you want to call it that you got to have every night of the week. Okay?
$2,000. It's all it would have taken. It's okay, honey. Dad's just having a meltdown. Good night.
You gotta try some different kinds of breakfast foods, okay? Hey, Mikey, tomorrow we'll have pancakes.
I don't want any more cereal.
Eat up, otherwise you don't get to play with Corky, okay?
What?
Nothing. Why are you always asking what?
I'm not always asking what.
Yes, you are.
It's true, Dad, you are.
Well, because I know there's something.
And you know exactly what it is.
Then why do you always say nothing?
Corky!
You hold Lula's hand, honey.
Corky!
So beautiful.
Great horse, Corky.
Corky happens to be a sweet and gentle horse, and me and the kids love him.
Corky happens to shit the size of a bread basket in our yard every day when he comes to visit.
I'm just throwing away some more completely useless inventions.
Oh, for Christ's sake, Debbie. Light? Come on. Come on. This was shit. You think Edison would have even looked up from his workbench at some shit spray?
Oh, yes. Yes, I do. Because you see, a good invention is a good invention.
Well, I got news for you, sister. Edison ain't looking up.
Sister. Sister.
I'm calling you sister.
You should be so lucky to be my sister. Oh. Yeah, my sister knows what she's talking about.
Wind talker, whatever the hell
it is. Do not tell her that she's called Windsong.
Windsong, my mistake, Windsong.
Knockety, and knock, knock, knock. How's everybody doing?
Whoa. What a day, right?
Oh my God. Can you believe the coffee that thing makes? I knew you were going to love it. Let's go, Tiger.
Oh, look who's
glass here, will you please? Look who's here. It's okay, Poopy. Have you been stealing apples again, you little rascal?
Listen, and I want you to be honest. Has Corky become a nuisance?
Not one bit.
Because Natalie keeps saying, keep the corral closed, but Corky's so crazy about your apples, I don't know what to do. No more apples for you. No more apples. I can't stop him. And he loves your apples. Are you sure he's not a problem?
Positive.
You guys are so fantastic. Well, my buddy boy, let's go shoot us some golf. Something for you. I'll be right back.
Nick, no. Nick,
yes.
Please.
You
Nick, you don't have to get me anything else.
You know, when I get it big, everyone said I should buy a house in Beverly Hills or Bel Air or Malibu. Why are you spending all that money on a mansion in the valley? But I love my neighborhood, and I love being across the street from my best friend.
Do you see how it moves in the wind? That's what I love. It flaps different than cheaper fabric. Do you notice that?
Yeah.
And it makes you feel better. Nice fabric makes you feel better.
Just you and me playing golf?
This is costing a fortune.
Well, you cut it out with this money thing. It means nothing to me. Let's just enjoy it.
Why can't you come with us?
Because Daddy's got to stay home and go to work. That's why. But you're going to have a great time at Aunt Nancy's.
Aunt Windsong, and you know that. It's Aunt Windsong now.
Honey, you don't have to do this. Really. Why do this?
Because I have to do this. We have to do this. Something has to change. And I can't look at you. I can't look across the street. I'm running out of places to look. Let the poor people come tomorrow.
Across the fence, dollars when you ain't got sense. It's bound to be a man yet tense. It's who really got what do die in me.
Section 11. You wanted to see me? You all right?
What?
You seem distracted.
What? God.
Now, your performance chart's pretty good until here. And then your focus nosedives into the red.
See? Now, is there anything that happened around here that might like to talk about?
No.
You sure?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no.
Anyways,
reason no.
Any reason at all?
No. No reason, no. I mean, nothing I can think of. I mean, you know, other than every day I get into my little shitbox car and there he is with the wind in his hair on his great big shiny horse. And I drive off to do what? To make sandpaper. To make paper with sand on it. I would love to see you try to turn your weaselly little mouth into a fake smile.
day after day after day. While you have to wait two to fucking do to your best friend who's rearing up on a big white horse like he's the Lone Ranger. Then I'd like to take a peek at your performance chart, you beady-eyed little shrimp-boat bastard! Is that a reason? I mean, is that a reason?
Got yourself in trouble today. Fweet apple vive de soup anyway. It's gonna be hell today.
Hi. Yeah, look, I don't really drink, but my family just left me and I got fired. And I want a drink, so just give me whatever you have if you wanted to drink. Please.
Know what the best job I ever got fired from was? Pretzel kiosk. Afternoon shift, just loved it. Don't know why, just did. Could be the apron, who the hell knows, or maybe the feeling of power you get when there's a crowd, you know, on one hand's rolling the dough, tying those babies off, the other hand's maybe working the soda, refilling the mustard. It's quite a thing, quite a thing. But I'll tell you a little secret. If a pretzel is a quality pretzel, you don't need salt. It's just a... I hear you. Man, I hear you. What'd you go and blow up at your boss for?
You know, it's like a long, complicated story.
Well, that is sensational. I'm the J-Man, by the way.
Tim.
Ike. Not around, please. Something fruity. For me and my friend Tim. I'm the J-Man. Okay, Tim. Just let it tumble out like circus freaks, man. I'm here for you. The J-Man is zeroed in, okay? Go.
Well, I have this friend. He's my best friend. I love the guy. I mean, it's like we're, you know, our families do everything together.
Good.
Just to go to work together every day.
Keep it coming, keep it coming.
And he'd have these stupid, he'd have these stupid ideas.
Open your heart. Open your heart.
And where does it come from? Shit. It's all from shit.
You know who you are. You're like that guy. Jay something.
Jay something?
Up with the people. People power. Or that kid that stole a chicken with the golden eggs. What a fantastic chicken. Who's for the giant? Nobody. You hear what I'm saying? You're the hero. Forget Jay. You're like Robin Hood.
Robin Hood?
Listen to me.
Really?
Listen to me. Life's unfair. It's a raw deal, Planet Jack. You, my little dumbbell friend, are Mr. Everyman, and you don't even know it, which makes you like the Grand Turbo, Mr. Everyman.
Honestly?
Come on. You're like a great big dimwit. You know that fantastic Everyman dimwit. That stinking family across the street. Who wouldn't feel like you?
I like you. I'm glad I came in here. You know that?
Ringlets, give me a break. Let me tell you a little story, my friend. When I was maybe 10, there was this kid across the street. Ernie, nice kid. Ernie had everything. Only kid around with a BB gun, okay? Thought one night I see the whole family drive off. What I do? I sneak across the street and find the BB gun. I squeeze off maybe 5-10 pot shots at the windows. Hello, in my house.
In your house?
Yes, you got...
You squeeze off to your house?
You got it. Next morning, my old man gets up, sees all these little BB holes in our windows. Uh-oh. He marches across the street, bangs on the door, and Tim, my little Bozo friend, things changed big time. over there in Ernieville. That's what you gotta do.
What?
Shake things up over there, man. Shake them up. Give them something to think about besides the temperature in that candy-ass swimming pool.
Oh, shit, what time is it?
What kind of question is that?
Oh,
I gotta get back. I can't fill the pool. Oh. Hi, Bab. Oh, J-Man.
Something from your great friends across the street while your wonderful family is away.
Such a big joke, too, so we're never going to vineyard.
Corky. Oh my god, how is this possible? How could a little arrow kill a big horse? Come on, Corky. Corky, come on. Come on, it's just an arrow. Just a little arrow. Come on, Corky.
Cock-a-doodle-doo. Car return. How's that for service? I'd probably still be driving a limo if it wasn't for the hat. Hats
make my head itch.
Time is... Man, you got a time hang-up.
Oh, God. Oh, look at me.
I was thinking the same thing. You are one big stinking pig, Tim.
How'd you get my keys?
Keys? The J-Man don't usually need keys. A little dumbbell pal. So...
That's the place, huh? Look at it. Awful shit, I see what you mean. I don't even live here in that place over there. It's pulling my testicles up. I mean, literally, they're actually coming up.
You ever get that?
I killed his horse.
What?
I killed his horse. That story you're telling about shaking things up, I went over there, I shot this bow and arrow, and I shot at my house, and I hit his horse. He was eating apples in my yard. And then there was a hole, because we were going to have a pool, and I buried him in it.
Well, now.
Oh, it's my family. Hide!
Hide?
Hide! Hide! No!
Don't I just mosey off?
No! Don't mosey off! No, can't mosey off. I'll see you. So, what are you doing here? Who are you? You're some guy from a bar.
What's wrong with the... I'm the J-Man, bringing your car back.
What the...
Hide! Daddy!
Hey, Tiger! Nina!
One question. What is at the heart of everything? What I'm asking you is, what is at the heart of the heart of the heart of the heart of the heart? Do you know what the answer is? Self-love. See, Winsong told me that I've been hating myself for resenting you, and you've been resenting yourself for passing up on a big opportunity. What we need to do is we need to focus on what we have.
Hey! Oh, hey! This guy! Honey, this man is the man who's in the bathroom. I didn't tell you. Honey, something happened while you were gone. Something really bad.
What?
I'll take it from here, Tim. Mrs. Dingman, I'm Elmo Karp, pool rat. Your husband and I were up here discussing your swimming pool options.
Swimming pool options?
Yes. You see, we dug it. We had to fill it back in. We're sorry as heck. Where do we go from here? That's the point we're at when you botched in.
Don't understand. Fill it back in? So you mean we're not getting a pool?
No, sonny boy, I'm afraid not. Too many guys on pipes.
Pipes?
Yes, underground pipes in your yard. But I've intruded enough on your little family reunion here. I'll be on my way. Oh, and thanks for filthying up your clothes. Help me fill in the big hole.
Natalie Vanderpark, and I'm running for state senate in your district, so I thought I would canvass the neighborhood and introduce myself to everyone.
Who is it, Mabel?
It's that woman running for state senate, Carl.
The shit lady? No way. We're going with Shaughnessy.
You know, your opponent, Shaughnessy, he asked a good question on the radio this morning.
And what question was that?
Well, did your husband get loaded making turds disappear?
My husband is the inventor of the Vaporize, if that's what you're referring to.
Yeah, that's what Shaughnessy was talking about. Where do all them turds go? I mean, they gotta be somewhere. First they're here, then they're not here, then they disappear. Where does the turd go to? You really tell me now.
A man who has to falsify can't look the truth right in the eye. His call for help is a pathetic cry. His deck's a few cards shy. Envy.
So long, everybody.
Bye, honey. Have a good day at work.
Bye, Daddy.
Bye, honey.
Good luck at the salt mines, Dad.
Where am I going?
Wait. Timmy, wait. Wait. Oh, God. Timmy, I can't find him. I've been looking all night, and I was nowhere. I know, he's just a horse, but... Corky, where are you, my Corky boy? Oh, God, look at me, this is crazy. Will you pass these out down at 3 a.m. for me? I found some
rooming here is an escape
$50,000?
It's pennies! Pennies! Who cares? Gorky's my pal! He's my pal, and I'd pay $50,000 to find you if you were lost, wouldn't I? Wouldn't I?
Should have took the high road when you had the chance. Now you're on the low road, just shitting in your pants. Don't live a life of lies and fear. Don't dodge the truth behind a tear. You wind up crying in your beard.
Insane. But that, see, that is the most selfish thing I ever heard in my life. The guy loves you, man. You'd be killing your best friend. You killed his horse, right? You killed his horse. Now you want to tell him? You tell him?
What about this? We move the horse someplace else. I find that I get the reward. I'm bending over backwards here.
How do we move a horse?
We dig him up. We haul him off.
Oh, I mean,
without anybody seeing us.
You have a hearing night?
What about the noise? My family. My family's right there. I don't want them to...
We don't move the horse. I do. You and your family are enjoying nature. Down in my cabin on the lake.
You have a cabin on the lake?
What?
You think I didn't have a childhood? Bunk beds, hiking trails, hootie owls.
You can move a horse by yourself?
$50,000.
But I will say this. Knowing what I happen to know about things buried, the sooner the better.
Hey, Deb?
Mm-hmm?
How would you like to go to a nice cabin on a lake?
Cabin on a lake?
Yeah. This guy at work offered to let us use his cabin. It's supposed to be really nice.
Well, who at work offered you this?
Jackemeyer. Jack Jackemeyer. It's like an hour from here, and it's supposed to have all sorts of wildlife, booty owls and stuff, hiking trails. Finds a lake first, all right? Winner gets 50 cents. Huh? 50 cents. Come on. Let's check it out. Oh. Ooh. Okay. Weird smell. Let's hold our noses. Come on.
It's okay, Mikey. Come on in.
Yeah! Oh! Ooh, it's okay. Just a little critter. Just... Don't touch it. He's dead.
Under no circumstances is this a lake.
Maybe there's a tide.
But no one would ever find this lake. Congratulations. You save yourself 50 cents. What is that?
even and upped your ass with mobile gas.
Mobile gas?
See any neighbors?
What do you think Bosco would lie? Why would Bosco lie? I'll go get him right now if you want. I'll go get him.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes. I'd like to ask him about this owl.
I don't want to bring him in here. He's big. He might, you know, the floorboards.
How big?
How big?
Yes.
Big. He's like a bear of a guy. He's like a little head. I don't know what that means. Look, I'm going to go help this guy because Wynn's so unsure he's going to help this guy. Okay? I'm going to be back.
Ask me about crumbs, man, because I am on the edge of the edge.
Hello?
Natalie just stormed out of the bedroom. We had a terrible fight. You gotta come over here now. I know you got your army pal over there. You know, I didn't even know you were in the army.
No. I'll come over there. I'm coming.
Okay, good. Thanks.
Yeah, no. I'll come over there. I'm coming over. I'll come there. Here I come. I gotta go across the street for a second.
No. That is incorrect. Follow me. This was no picnic, let me tell you. They had an 88 Ford flatbed all lined up with a brand new winch, but I fried it during the hot wire, goddammit. Good thing Monk passed out, or I'd never got this baby. Whoa.
What in the shit is this? What is it?
It's winches, hoists, pulleys, blocks and tackles, this kind of thing. You know how I got the idea that...
horse on the van.
And rope?
Yeah, and don't make any noise. Simple, okay? All right? I'll be right back.
Yeah.
Oh, hello, Mr. Tim. You're looking very sprightly for the hour. We go up the stairs, please. Right this way.
I've never been in this park.
Oh, they are practicing for the tournament. Incredible friend.
What the hell was that?
That's bowling. The bowling next door. Get ready for your tournament.
Oh, the tournament.
Doing good. They're hitting strikes.
She's been blaming me for Corky.
Cool.
She just kept blaming me for Corky and making me feel guilty. Then she starts up with the shit thing.
Uh-huh. How do I know where the shit goes?
I mean, I tell her, hey, I'm going to Rome tomorrow.
And she freaks out. She has a complete flip out. She flips out the room.
Where'd she go?
Oh, no. Some other way. Listen. This Italy thing is huge. It could mean literally billions.
You know what? You know what I think this is? I think you just gotta get some sleep, you know?
Yeah.
I think you gotta just shut everything down, get under the covers. Come on.
I did.
Get under the covers. Don't listen to anything. Sometimes you think you're hearing things.
You know, you're a great friend.
Etc.
What about here? Right here.
You kidding? There's towns around. Want somebody else finding my horse?
There's gonna be towns everywhere. Hey, 6 months. I drove a yoga truck, okay? This is my territory, Jack. Go wandering along the mountain track. And when I go, I love to sing my knapsack on my back.
A sofa. What kind of sofa? Oh, man. I love to wander by the stream that dances in the sun. So joyously, it oh, my God. What is this? Oh, no.
The bridge is out. Follow the detour along the river to the next bridge, all right?
Thank you very much. Have a good night.
Let's go.
Didn't notice the horse. Smokey didn't even notice that we got a horse on the bridge.
It's amazing. I can't believe you didn't see it.
I'm smoking. No, it's not good.
What's wrong right here?
It doesn't feel right.
Okay, because I hope it's very soon, because I gotta be back. I gotta be back there. I mean, it's gonna be flying out.
You're sleeping. Nobody even knows you left.
I'm doing you a favor doing this.
Okay, how about here? Huh? What's wrong here?
I dig up the horse, I hold it up, I invent everything.
Why don't we have to do what you want to do?
This is not good for me.
Forget it. This is it right here.
Okay?
Bad vibe. And when I go, I love thinking my napkin on my back.
Check the nuts. Nuts. Who knows nuts?
Not you.
Well, you know, I'm not Popeye. How do we not hear that horse? How do you not hear a horse fall off the cart?
Maybe he's not dead. Maybe he ran away.
It's raining so hard, the horse might have fallen off and floated, who knows, into a ditch.
There's a river that runs along this road. He could be in it. Corky could be heading for the open sea.
Good morning, Mr. Tim. I must say, you're looking fit as a fiddle this morning, Mr. Tim.
Thanks. I was told Mr. Nick wants to see me.
Yes, I know. He's running in the woods.
Okay, I talked to the guys over at 3M. I know you got canned. You've met Pete, right? My trainer?
Hi.
Listen, hey, don't feel funny around Pete. I got no secrets from Pete. Do I, Pete?
I don't think so.
So here's the deal. Buddy boy, did my little hearty hi-ho silver routine each morning had that kind of effect on you? Man, all I can say is I am such a jerk, but it's the best thing that ever happened, because now I'm going to go kick ass in Rome. And guess what? You unemployed bum, you're going to come kick ass with me, because I want us to be partners. I want us to be equal again, man. Why not? I mean, for crying out loud, I've got a Pete. Why shouldn't you have a Pete? Wouldn't you like having a Pete? Of course you would. Who wouldn't? So this is the deal. From now on, you and me, 50-50.
50-50?
That's right. 50-50. I talked to my lawyer. You know, I don't know why I didn't think of this sooner. It's awesome. Now get the hell out of here. The limo leaves in an hour and a half. Buddy boy, let's go, buddy boy.
All right,
come on. Now pump it up. I'm a full cardio blast now.
Let's go.
Don't be shy.
There you go.
No, keep it there. Crampers.
You all right?
Crampers.
I don't know, honey. I mean, do you want to do this? I mean, do we want to be part of the shit industry? I mean, what about the heart of the heart of the heart of the heart, huh?
I don't think this conflicts with that. I mean, you know, there's a lot of money and the heart of the heart. And they're both
still have a heart and a lot of money, I think. You know?
You know what I think? I think I know what we should do. I think that we should just try it.
Try it?
Yes.
Try it.
Try it.
Try it.
Try it.
Yes.
We see how it feels.
Oh my God, I can't believe it! Oh.
I think we should target zoos.
Thank you, Denise. Zoos?
Yeah, zoos. I mean, come on. They're full of poop. You know, I popped on the internet just right before we got on the plane just to check things out. Did you know that an elephant goes like 100 pounds a day? So you times that by like 7? That's 700 pounds of dung a week for one elephant. There's got to be like, what, how many thousands of zoos in the world?
That is really very good. Zoos.
Okay, well, I got another one for you.
Yeah?
Travel industry. We get into the travel industry. I'm talking about little travel-sized vaporize.
You mean like the cute little shampoo bottles?
Exactly.
Hey, God, that's so simple and awesome.
You're on a trip. You want to walk through Venice. You step in some dog dew, right? And you want to spray it. So what do? You take out your little travel-sized vaporize.
That's it.
A holster. A little Velcro holster you put on your belt right next to your cell phone, your pager, your vaporize. You can do like a hands-free walk in the dog. You don't have to worry about carrying the vaporize.
I love a holster.
Accessorize with vaporize.
Hold on. Let me take it from here. You're walking along, doobly-doo. All of a sudden,
you're trapped in poo! You don't know what to do. What do you do?
I don't know what to do.
Vaporize! Vaporize! Mountain-scented vaporize!
What is a dooka-dooka? I thought there'd be like drums behind me.
Okay, yeah.
Sluggish day on Wall Street. On the International Financial Front, investors are keeping an eye on Vanderpark Enterprises as CEO Nicholas Vanderpark and newly appointed partner Tim Dingman arrive in Italy to introduce to the European nations their complete line of fecal-removing product that has had such remarkable success in the United States. American entrepreneurs have reason to be hopeful as they were greeted with great enthusiasm everywhere and fanfare. Later, they'll be feted at a banquet to be held in the presidential palace.
Io ho notato quando siamo entrati in la vasca che I nostri membri erano simili di misura e grandezza.
He says, I noticed when we climbed into the tomb, our three penises were quite similar in size and bone.
Ha detto a me stesso, bene.
He say, and I thought to myself, good. Envy is a funny thing.
Io e un amico armato abbiamo passato un'estate a New York, un bel periodo della vita.
He said, I remember when I was a teenager, my friend Armando and I spent a summer in New York. A sweet time of life.
Ma questo ragazzo, Armando, dico, aveva un membro. Come un treno merci, capisci? Un treno merci!
The main minister, he says, I must tell you, my friend Armando had a halt like a freight train.
What a halt.
Devo dire segretamente che la misura grandissima del membro di Armando mi ha fatto sentire con la mia misura normale miserabile.
He says, and I must tell you secretly, Armando's freight train size man route made me, with a regular size one, quite miserable.
Non sempre miserabile, certo, ma qualche volta.
Not all the time miserable, of course, but some. Equi, aspetta. This call has been transferred to you.
Thank you.
Hello?
Turbo every man my ass.
And I'll tell you another thing. Where do you get off at? I bought you drinks, you vacation in my bungalow, and now you go jump
ship. Screw Robin Hood, you hear me? Screw the merry men, you're a stinko pinko.
Panko.
Here's what I do, Mr. Trader.
Remember Lester? He pumped our gas.
When we moved the sofa. Got a tooth in his head, nice fellow.
Remember him now?
I do,
yes.
Yep. Mm-hmm. $50,000. Lester, keep thinking. It's a sofa. And me and him don't go spill the beans to your big hoity-toity pal across the street. Let's be very clear on this. I want $50,000, or I tell your friend you killed this horse.
Good. Dr. Weitzman is supposed to be a genius, and it didn't even really hurt. And that is not all. Come, I'm so excited. Look at the little gift I bought for us. A little 50-50 surprise. My big international partner.
We want to do it on the laundry.
Where are the kids?
The mothers, honey. It's just us. Then we rely on the worm pile. It's all fresh. It's all clean out of the dryer.
I will lie with you after I tell you something. It's very important. I got drunk and I accidentally killed Corky. I buried him in the swimming pool hole in the backyard. The pool guy, he's actually some bum I met in a barn been hanging out in.
Nick, where does it go?
What?
The shit? Where does the shit go?
Up.
Up is not good enough. You're going to have to do better than up.
Up? And out.
Out where?
Up and out. Out. Up and out.
Up and out.
Up and out.
With the bomb on $50,000, we'll tell Nick everything and then we won't have a chance to be rich.
Oh my God. Yes. Yes, yes. Go and pay the bum. Go pay the bum.
Go pay the bum.
Pay the bum.
Go pay the bum. Come on, come on. I love you.
I love you too. Bye, 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 bye.
Oh. What? You don't know this guy. I mean, he's not like other people. He's, I mean, what if we pay him and then he wants more?
Then we will... give him more.
No, but what if he wants more after that?
Honey, we will give him more money because we will have enough money to give him.
But Debbie, this guy, it'll never end with him. I mean, he'll be in our lives forever.
Tim, if he tells Nick, it'll all be over. You know, what else can we...
Gotta give Natalie a little talk. She's locked herself in the bathroom, and I want what you have so bad. I want some of that.
Okay. Shh. Don't say a word. Shh. Not a word. Shh. Okay.
Everywhere I go, they're yelling at me. Where does this shit go? And we don't know. What if my opponent's right? What if we are polluting?
Natalie, the only thing this guy Shaughnessy's got going for him is your own guilt. Guilt that you're wealthy. You know what? We're partners now, and we have money, too. And you know what we're going to do with ours? We're going to sponsor the biggest rally for you that this town has ever seen. And then we are going to throw out this challenge. We are going to say that if anyone can say that Babe Ruiz does damage to anything, then Natalie Vanderpark will cease to be a candidate. May I suggest we put on our dancing shoes?
How was the flight? Was it enjoyable?
Yeah, it was fine. It was very smooth. Everything went fine.
Listen, here's what I got to tell you. We're going to pay you the money, okay? We got it all worked out.
That is sensational news, my little gypsy roving friend. But I've revised my thinking about the 50 grand thing. I can't accept that. I mean, what are we, animals?
What? No, we're not animals.
Of course not.
What we are is pals. You slept in my bunk. I ate some of your crackers we sang in the rain. Valdery, Valdera.
My knapsack on
my back. Yes, I remember.
That's when we were buddies.
Last week? Yeah, I remember.
So?
What I'm saying is to help with the flat cash payout. I say let's be partners.
Partners?
Why not?
Wait, what do you mean partners?
You're on the so-called friend and a cozy little triumvirate, am I using the word correctly?
No, listen to me. We're not partners, okay? How can we be partners? We don't...
We'll iron out the details when I come over later.
No.
This evening.
No.
Who the hell knows exactly when?
Hey, you listen to me. You're not coming over here.
And don't you worry, buddy partner. I'll smooth out the rough parts.
Okay, you want to talk? I'll come to you.
Tell
me, where were you?
I'm coming over.
No, you're not coming over.
Don't you worry, buddy Roll. We'll put pen to paper. Bye-bye.
Hey, listen to me.
Bye-bye.
There are no rough parts to smooth. What? Hello?
Oh, God. All right, I gotta tell Nick. Tell him.
Most ridiculous thing.
Listen, that wife of yours, man, she was incredible. But I'll tell you one thing. I don't care how much money we make. Don't buy one of these. It's junk. Just keeps on speeding up for no reason.
Nick, I gotta talk to you.
And the thing is, they put the on-off button in the middle, if you can believe that.
Listen to me. I did this horrible thing. We gotta talk about
it. The thing is in the middle.
Well, here it goes.
Talk about this fantastic rally.
Nick, look, this is bone arrow.
Yeah?
One night. I'm so ashamed of this. But one night.
Oh my God. Oh man. Oh, I told you it was a piece of junk.
I'm glad we weren't on it.
What?
I said I'm glad we weren't on it.
Hey, I can't hear you. Are your ears ringing?
No.
Boy, mine are. Well, what was it you were saying, my fine friend?
What I was saying is that one night I got drunk, right? And I mean, being drunk had nothing to do with it. I can't even explain it. Just one night...
Wait, you know what? I'm thinking it's just one ear.
I hear you way better when I turn like this. Say it some more. Talk
right,
some more.
Look,
talk to me.
Well, that night, I got drunk, okay? And I was aiming this arrow at my house like this.
No, it's both ears. What are you doing?
I'm trying to tell you. I pulled it back. I aimed at the house. I did this.
Wait a second. I heard that.
Nick.
I'm coming. That was not a smart thing to do.
I know.
Come on.
No, Nick. Nick, I gotta tell... Oh, shit! Oh! Huh?
Timmy!
What?
Honey, where are you? Timmy! Honey, I got it! Definitely in the hip. Timmy, where have you been?
I killed the bum.
What?
The bum! I shot an arrow! It went up, it went down, it's in the bum! I killed him! Come, go!
Hey, did you work out a deal with
him? No, he's dead! In the window, it's in his back, the arrow! I shot him, I killed him! I killed a person, I killed him!
What? Is this a joke? I don't get your joke sometimes. And I'm gonna tell you something. I don't think it's always me.
Hurry up! Come on!
Honey!
Come on.
Wait! Stop! What are you doing?
Wait! Get me in the house!
There's nobody there!
Just Tar! Look at he's crazy!
Honey, this is really insane!
Get in! Get in!
Sticking in my back, please.
Arrow.
Freaking nitwit. Look, I'm being stalked by a genuine madman, okay? I'm talking about a black force here. I hate spoiling the atmosphere, but would you mind tugging the arrow out?
I want you to stop the car. Honey, stop the car. Now stop the car right
what?
Now.
Look, this guy's crazy.
There is no dead man.
He's a loose cannon.
Excuse me.
Oh, my God, there is a bum with an arrow. He looks afraid of us.
You ever hear of reach for the sky? You just shoot a guy in the back with no warning.
That's right. That's correct. That's right. That's what I do.
Well, then, good God Almighty, we have entered indeed into a dark day. You got to talk to him. We were pals. Who shoots a pal in the back with a bow and arrow? Over a couple of bucks.
Me? I'm an archer. And I shoot arrows. And I got more back at where they came from. My quiver.
You gotta listen to me. I just wanted what you wanted. A little taste of the good life. A little taste of honey. Is that so bad, is it? But you win. Man, I fold. I can see it. Greed has hardened your heart. And money's poisoned your soul. I'm out of here! There's nothing as dangerous as large quantities of money. That's why I've always remained an independent contractor and odd-job man. I want no part of this. I stand before you, begging. Take the arrow out of my back. You will never see me again. Help me, God! Come on!
I couldn't sleep. I gotta talk to you.
Yeah, I gotta talk to you, too.
You know, this big rally tomorrow, I'm a wreck about it. I gotta give a big speech. I'm not a speech guy.
Oh, Nick, are you kidding? Come on, those infomercials you did, you're
great in front of people.
Really? You thought I was good? You never said a word about it.
Because it was just another thing of yours that made me miserable.
What?
This is what I have to talk to you about. Here, sit down. I killed Corky.
Zit.
Now, please, just don't say anything until I'm done, all right? The day that you gave me the wine, remember? I got drunk on the wine. I actually was drunk from before, and I went over into your yard, and I was... So that's it. There you have it.
Well, you know, it sounds like it was an accident. Why didn't you tell me?
I should have told you. That's the thing. I should have just told you, but I don't know what happened. I felt guilty or something. I was just so wrapped up in the envy that I felt for everything you had. I mean, it's true what they say. It's like a little green monster that comes out and it just poisoned my head. I mean, and by the way, you did nothing wrong. I mean, you did nothing wrong. You just followed your dream. You did what you wanted to do. And I was always saying, don't do it, don't do it. And you did it, and it worked. I mean, it worked. Look, you built a house, right? That's all you did. You built a house. I mean, it's a big house. I mean, it's a really big house. It's a large house. It's gigantic, Nick. It's the White House. You built the White House across the street, and we're in the shadow of it. I mean, literally, every day at 4 o'clock, we're in the shadow of it. You know, and that's not your fault. I mean, you wanted to be friends still, and you didn't want to move, and I love that. I mean, that's such a, you know, it's coming from such a good place, but it was just, I mean, it really was getting to me, because every day I'd have to look at you and see you with all of this stuff, you know, buy the yellow Lamborghini that goes 500 miles an hour. Have a bowling alley next to your bedroom. If I could do it, I would have done it. Everybody should have a merry-go-round. Of course you should have a merry-go-round. Jealousy every day, and it was just chewing me up. I mean, your kids play the concert piano, my kids banging trash cans. And I don't think that has anything to do with the money. I think that's just his musical ability, but that's a whole other thing. And you just gave to us, Nick. I mean, you gave, and you gave, and you're so generous. And what am I going to give you? I gave you tube socks for Christmas last year. That's not going to work.
I like the socks.
You gave us so much, the coffee machine. It's a beautiful, giant, rocket ship-sized coffee machine. And Debbie loved the coffee. I'll tell you something. I never tasted it. I've been wanting to tell you that for a long time. I mean, it's that bad. I can't even tell you I haven't tried the coffee. Like, it's going to make me feel better about myself that I won't drink your coffee. And you gave our kids flan. And then, all of a sudden, my son's going, Daddy, Daddy, where's the flan? I want the flan. And I just want to... It felt like a dagger in my heart, the flan, every time you'd request flan. And it just made me feel little. I felt like a little man who didn't like flan. That's what I felt like, Nick. And the horse was great, Nick. Of course you should have a horse. Does it have to be a white horse that you come galloping up on and it neighs and it makes a whole thing? Of course, make it a beautiful white horse that I think, honestly, didn't like me. It had nothing to do with anything other than I just don't think I clicked with the horse. I mean, I think the horse sensed something. You know, they say horse sense. I think that's a real thing, Nick. Because the horse had a feeling. He would come over and he sensed the envy that I was feeling. And he would come over and he'd eat the apples and he would look at me and he gave me a weird look. I'm telling you, you know how sometimes the side of the face, and you get one eye? That eye, he would keep the eye on me, and I knew that he was thinking something. And that has nothing to do with what happened with the arrow, because that was an accident, Nick. I swear to God, I couldn't do it if I tried. I'm sorry about this. I feel horrible. I feel bad. I feel like I have this fountain in my yard that I don't deserve. I don't deserve to be your partner. I don't deserve to be your friend. I just...
Well, you know what, Tim? You made a mistake. You're human. Everyone makes mistakes. So what, man? You're still my best friend.
Really?
Of course. Of course. Come on, man.
It was a big mistake. I mean,
it was a big mistake. It was a doozy.
Okay. I'm sorry, Nick.
No, it's okay.
Really, I know how much you loved him. But...
I did love Corky. I never liked Corky.
I mean, he's beautiful, you know, on the outside. It just something wasn't it.
Well, we're still partners. There is no way you are getting out of this partnership.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
And I will see you tomorrow at the big rally.
Yeah.
Good. Big day.
Big day.
Poor Corky. One little target arrow. You wouldn't think that could kill it.
poisoning our environment in our efforts to purify it. It's not true. No es verdad. No es verdad. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Nick Vanderpark and Tim Dignan.
Ladies and gentlemen, young people, I stand here with my partner, Tim Dingman. That's right. Grateful for this opportunity to address the central question posed in so many colorful and eloquent variations. Where is the shit?
Mr. and Mrs. Vanderpark, sorry we had to perform an autopsy, but when any large dead animal comes into proximity with the general public, it must be examined immediately for health reasons. Now, I'm just a little curious. Did you feed your horse a lot of apples?
Well, our neighbors have an apple tree. Corky loved their apples.
And did the horse ever defecate in the yard?
I imagine.
Can you tell me what you did when the horse defecated in your yard?
We used vaporize because Nick invented it. We get crates of it for free.
Well, it's all making sense.
Huh?
The horse was poisoned. We did find the broken shaft of a small target arrow in the sternum, but that played no part in the horse's death. The horse died from the prolonged ingesting of a certain chemical, which by itself is harmless, but when combined with certain fecal bacteria, becomes a lethal poison.
A little person?
Lethal poison. That chemical, I'm afraid, is a third ingredient in every can of your so-called miracle invention. He had enough of it literally to kill a horse. I am obligated, of course, to report this to the EPA, huh?
EPA?
Uh-huh.
Environmental Protection Agency? Uh-huh. Do you have to do that? You have to, right, you have to. Every time, without exception.
Sleeps 9 comfortably for, let's say, $100. XL bed, sleeping 9, gotta love it, for $100. $72, anyone, for this white statue of a man on a horse with a spray can? $72, anyone? No?
Anybody need a portable phone? Everyone needs a portable phone. You want one in your kitchen, your extra bedroom? We got a portable phone right there, it's gonna go for $5. Exactly. The next thing we got, oh, item 31.
That's like this 31. Bug net, why don't we find out what the estimated cost?
Oh, we've got 2 cases of semi-gourmet flan. I believe that's some sort of custard dish or something. The semi-gourmet flan is going to start the bidding at $4.
Nick,
$4
right there. Yeah.
I think I have an idea.
Yeah?
Yeah, like a really big idea.
Really?
When you got your big idea, did you feel it immediately? Like it was...
Oh, yeah. Right away. Is that one of those? Like one of my ideas?
I think so.
What is it?
Yes!
Hey, stop the auction!
You just cannot eat flan and drive at the same time. Look, I've got flan all over me. Can't somebody come up with a better idea?
We have.
That's right! Be one of the millions of people enjoying the taste sensation that's sweeping the nation.
Nick's talking about pocket flan!
Pocket flan!
No spoon, no mess!
That's right, 3 simple steps, folks. Just flip it!
Flip it!
Squeeze it!
Squeeze it!
Mmm! And enjoy!
Tim.
Yeah.
What was that name again?
Pocket flan!
Isn't that just fantastic?
No, Nick, it's not fantastic. It's flantastic.
Tim, Nick, I have a question. How about us who are lactose intolerant?
We've got a new soy-based pocket flan.
Now you...
too. It's, you know what? It's a little bit of happiness in a tube.
Let's say I'm jogging. I'm getting kind of tired. I need to pick me up. What am I going to do? A good candy bar?
Yeah, imagine if you're jogging with some of this stuff. Whoa. It's not going to work.
No, that's right. And here's the other thing. You're eating your flan. You're like, yeah. That's good. I want to get down there where it's brown and super sugary. Where do you go? I can't. And here, we've mixed it up.
That's right.
You've got all of that. It's already pre-mixed.
The brown is always part of it, even if you don't see it. Let me tell you something. In the Tour de France, when they're going 20 miles a day and they're going up mountains, what do you think they're pulling out of their little spandex bikini bottom in the back to squeeze it to their mouth when they want to get something to eat?
And here's another question. What if I'm doing some skydiving and I'm like, I gotta get some, I'm gonna get some cornflakes. I don't have time for cornflakes. I do have time for flan.
I would love to see this. This has been vacuum tested to a depth of at least 200 feet if you're scuba diving.
Just the other day, I see this kid walking down the street. He has the pocket flan,
right?
He squeezes it. He's on a skateboard. He squeezes it. It arcs up. He goes up. And
that's like a new trick. That's
like a
new skateboard
trick.
Hey, who here likes to drive, huh? You guys like to drive? Yeah. Who here likes to drive race cars? Anybody? All right.
I'm Captain Speedway, and nothing tastes better at 200 miles per hour than pocket flan.
Fireman, wait a second. I gotta go save someone. Maybe I need a little extra something.
Hey, wait a minute. Where am I gonna put my hose? I can't hold the hose and hold this thing, right? Where's the hose going under my arm? I put a hose under my arm, and then I'm trying to fight the fire.
This is on a serious note. Recently, we received a letter from a woman, Gladys, who, pocket flan saved her life. She was a backpacker. She was stuck out in the woods, and by God, pocket flan.
I wanted to say some tearful thing, but I couldn't think of it.
Say you love me. When you tend to go, you make others sorry. The broken heart you brought to my life, the bitter tears of a shameful life. Why you lied to me at the day you came? And why did you give me untrue dreams of living together too long enough? I know your soul as I know myself. You fool with me to date other guys. I know that you don't really love me. I just forgive and try to forget. Don't you really? Our faith has been done. Saturday I've been alone, walking around in the silent sound, till the end of the blurry way. I felt some things blowing my ears. Lonely night, my heart was beating. I'm calling, calling in whisper.